Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode here on Glee Info. Well, we'll be discussing something today which is concerning the Biafra and the Oduduwa Republic. They are considering an affiliation. They want to liaise together. Maybe this could help them achieve their dreams faster, because they say two heads are better than one. What do you think if the Yorubas and the Igbos come together to fight for one similar goal or one same goal? I think the forces and the connection will be much, much stronger, which might make them achieve their aims together. Because the Igbos have not been treated fairly in the country, and even the Yoruba activist Sunday Igboho has been clamoring for Oduduwa Republic. Well, let me read on so you can get a better picture of what we'll be discussing today. It's about, we are considering Oduduwa Biafra collaboration. Britain created hatred between Yoruba and Igbo. Well, Koki, who spoke with Sahara reporters, said the Yorubas and Igbos are brothers, but colonialists from Britain cast the aspersion of hatred between these two ethnic nationalities. Well, it is true that Britain colonized the most countries in Africa and even countries in the Western world. These people went about colonizing people, but they have left us a long time. This is over, I think, from 1960 to 2021. Is a long time for us to do something, for us to make this country work. But till date, nothing is working. Olayomi Yomi Koiki, spokesman for Yoruba Freedom Fighters Sunday Adeyemo, has revealed that there are possibilities that the Oduduwa Republic agitators will liaise with the Biafra Republic agitators to help them achieve their objectives faster. Koki, who spoke with the Sahara reporters, said the Yoruba and the Igbos are brothers, but colonialists from Britain cast the aspersion of hatred between these two ethnic nationalities. Well, he noted that 1914 amalgamation was responsible for the notion of enmity between the Igbos, Yorubas, and the Hausa. Koki said the Yoruba nation agitators have always enjoyed the support of their Igbo brothers, while reiterating Igboho's stance that any attack on Igbo people is an attack on the Yoruba people. He said, yes, we are looking in that direction. Well, this is just what we are saying here. This man is saying, if the Yorubas and the Igbos come together, I think they can get their freedom faster. But do we really want separation in our beloved country? Or do we really want Nigeria to come together and unite as one? I know that it has not really been okay, because the federal government or the government in Nigeria, those that have been, not only Buhari, from the very first, even from the Britain themselves, handing over power to the Fulani until date, plus Nnamdi Azikiwe and all the coup that has been happening, the head of states until present, they have not really helped Nigeria in moving this country further. Because if they have really done something, I think we'll have gotten better than where we are today. Africa as a whole has not really grown. Not to talk of a country in Africa. We saw some weeks ago whereby in the Pan-African group, when they were about electing, during the election, they were fighting there. So imagine all these hurdles and all these things happening in our beloved Africa. Well, I think we want peace in Nigeria. I'm not speaking to say that Nigeria should separate or there should be disintegration in our country. All I'm saying is that there should be unity in diversity. But if the federal government keeps on acting the way they're acting, if the federal government keeps on pushing the Igbos to one side, they will leave them with no choice than to find their square roots. Because anytime you ask a Northerner, or anytime you ask a Fulani man, he will say the Igbos cannot become president. The Igbos cannot rule Nigeria. Why? Are they not part of the country? These people see themselves as the first class citizens of Nigeria. These Fulanis, they see themselves as the first class citizens of Nigeria. They see that Nigeria belongs to them. That is why they can take their cattle and even go into different parts of the nation grazing openly. Just imagine the kind of gods they have. Why? Because it's their brother that is on the seat. President Muhammadu Buhari is from their side. So they see, since it's their brother that is on the seat, and since the Britain gave them the key to Nigeria, they see Nigeria as their property. So they can go about doing whatever they want to do, and this is not so. Every tribe, no matter their ethnicity, no matter your religion, no matter your tribe, you should be allowed to rule the country. There should be circulation, not just only one tribe. Now, Buhari has led the city. Before you know it, another northerner will come and take over. So this is what is causing some tribes like the Igbos, the Yorubas, clamoring for their own separate nation. They are not mad, they are not stupid. If everything is going well, if the national cake is being shared equally for every tribe and every community in Nigeria, nobody will want to leave the country, or nobody will be talking about separating from this nation. But it is obvious that the national cake is not shared equally to different tribes. Even from the sharing of states, right from our forefathers, you can see that partiality was done. Most of the states are northern states. How many are Igbos? How many are Yorubas? How many are Kwaibombs? So things have not been done right. I think Nigeria needs to be restructured from the constitution. From the constitution, Nigeria needs to be restructured so that everything can fall in place and the whole nation can move. Just imagine if our senators, our politicians, our presidents, those heading the government, just imagine if they have been making good use of the resources in this country. Nigeria would have been far better than Dubai. Nigeria would have been a country that tourists from all over the world would be running to come and stay, to come and find jobs in. Because I watched a video where a man in Dubai was saying Dubai has no natural resources. But they have been able to harness what the little they have, and they have been able to turn their country into a tourist site, turn their country into what it is today, where people are rushing to come and stay in Dubai. But Nigeria, with all our resources, with all our mineral resources, with all our blessings from God, still nothing to show for it. All we have in this country are politicians that have embezzled our resources and living their flamboyant life and spending and squandering our money. That is all we have. So how long will the Yorubas, the Igbos, keep on sitting down, closing their mouth and acting like if nothing is wrong? For how long will they keep on bearing this pain? For how long? We know that they tried in 1967 to gain Biafra, and they were not able to gain Biafra. And that was a genocide because so many died, so many women were raped during that process, so many children starved to death, and you know, we don't want that to happen again. So I think because of that reason, the federal government should work to make sure it unites the country, make sure that things that are meant to go to that east should go to the east. Should go to the east. And there should be a rotation when it comes to sharing all this political office. Because if these people are really part of Nigeria, then they should be allowed to rule the country. They should be allowed to take head positions in the Nigerian offices. But if you ask any northerner now, you say that no, if an Igbo man enter the office, the first agenda is they are going to separate Nigeria. How sure are you? Because of what happened in 1967, you are still holding the grudge till today. How can we move further? We can't move further. We can't move forward. And if you check, even what is happening in the north is far more worse than even in the southeast. It's far more worse. The northerners are the one handling Nigeria. They're the one controlling Nigeria. They're the most populated people in the country. But still, the north is still a place that you can't sleep with your two eyes closed. So what is the essence? What is the benefit? They are the one controlling the country, but still they cannot even manage the north. They cannot control the north. They cannot control the insurgency. They cannot control the insecurity in the north. So what is the essence? So I think the Igbos and the Oduduwa, maybe they are thinking of coming together. That is, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu coming together with Sunday Igboho. Maybe if they come together, the fight might become stronger. But we are all seeking
for freedom in diversity. We are all seeking for one Nigeria. Well, you can leave your comment in the comment section below. Let us know what you think concerning the Biafra Republic and the Oduduwa Republic. And if you're coming here for the first time, please and please, I would love you to hit that subscribe button, because if you hit that button, you'll be doing us a whole lot of favor. You'll be motivating us to create more quality content for you, and you'll be supporting us on this particular platform. Well, please keep subscribing, keep watching, keep commenting, keep liking, and please don't forget to share this video to all of your friends. Let us know what you think, and also hit that bell by the side. Whenever we drop our daily content, you will be the first to get notified. Keep watching, Glean Info, and God bless you.